So what is going on there, guys? I'm the King777HD here, and welcome to my new video. Today, I'm going to talk about potential FIFA 16 Ultimate Team Beasts, and in this episode, I would cover and talk about 6 of them. If you want to see more of these predictions or Ultimate Team videos, leave a comment and like this video. So the first player of this episode, we are going to have Chanzo Mamba. Chanzo Mamba, in my opinion, is looking forward to be the perfect replacement for Anucha. Anucha's team, also Queen's Park Rangers, having now been relegated to the Championship, so Anucha will not be in the Premier League and also have managed to get downgraded. And in my opinion, Chanzo Mamba looks like an absolutely incredible card with 85 jumping, 84 sprint speed, very good standing tackle and sliding tackle stats, and also the fact that you can actually replace him pretty much every single team you actually want, especially this sweaty Premier League teams. Seriously, this guy will be going to be so overused in the sweat Premier League teams, mainly because he have a lot of pace, but also great defending, physical, and also good, very good dribbling and ball control for a centre back. He have been very, very good for Anderlecht, and also very, very impressive for Newcastle so far. Looking like one of the best Newcastle defenders so far, without shadow about that. And yeah, his in-game stat looked incredible. We also have 83 strength, so like 84 sprint speed with good tackling stats, and also a lot of strength, will make this guy one of the most overpowered and quite possibly one of the most overused centre backs in the whole game. So the next player we have, Haris Mendunjanin. There are actually 4 players this year to have all stats over 70 that you can see actually in the picture right here. We have 4 players that have all in like base card stats over 70, with Dumbia. It's actually called the Dumbia clan because Dumbia is actually the highest amount of base card stats in the whole Ultimate Team. Both of with Gillette and Richardson. These are the players that have all stats over 70, and on the bench you can see the players that almost have all stats over 70. So it means pretty much that this year we have some incredible silver and a lot of great all-rounded players. But in my opinion, Mendunjanin have been one of the best looking so far, in my opinion, because of his absolutely incredible in-game stats. This guy have 85 free kick accuracy, 84 dribbling, 83 shot power, 81 long shot, and also 80 short passing. Seriously, these stats for a silver player are absolutely incredible, and I'll be not surprised if I actually see this guy a lot in like even gold Liga BBVA teams this year. Seriously, this guy have possibly never seen such a overpowered stats for a non-inform silver card in my life, pretty much. Seriously, this guy used to also have like 50 defending last year, which is pretty ridiculous because now I have 70 defending, which makes him even more overpowered. So Mendunjanin, in my opinion, looks like an absolute monster this year, and I would be not surprised to see this guy in even like a gold teams or even like expensive hybrids or something like that. Seriously, incredible cards. Next player is Luciano Vietto. Luciano Vietto have been one of the most overpowered silver cards last year. Seriously, last year Luciano Vietto's silver card was so incredibly overpowered because this guy had 82 pace and 77 shots for a silver card. Them stats were absolutely incredible. This year he's actually a non-rare. He have maybe managed to get upgraded last year to a gold card actually, but this year he have been even boosted even more. But this year around, he's actually a non-rare player. He's a 79 rated striker card, but he have some incredible in-game stats. People were obviously not really looking forward to this card because of his dribbling, because he is not he have lost the pace, he only have 79 pace, oh my god. But look at his in-game stats: 87 finishing, 86 dribbling, 85 positioning for a non-rare gold card. In my opinion, makes him one of the better, one of the most overpowered looking non-rare card in the whole entire game. Seriously, these in-game stats are absolutely out of this world. Also the fact that he also have like good physical and good passing stats, makes him absolutely perfect center forward card. And I'll be not surprised to see this guy pretty much every single starter team in FIFA 16. Seriously, Luciano Vietzel this year, maybe not the same pace, but seriously, his stats looks absolutely incredible. Next player, we have a player that surprised me a lot, and that is Wellington Silva, because he used to play in the Spanish league, but now, after his loan spell have actually ended in the Spanish league team, he have managed to transfer or be loaned out to Boats, and seriously, Boats and having a 5-star skill is absolutely mind-blowing in my opinion. But in my opinion, going to make championship teams much more enjoyable this year, because you have actually got 2 5-star skillers this year. We have got the Wellington Silva, also Botaka, that actually managed to get transferred to Leeds. And Wellington Silva have been one of my favorite 5-star skillers last year, not only because he was very fast, but had a great dribbling and a lot of agility and balance that make him an absolute unique 5-star skiller. And this year around, there is no different. This guy looks absolutely incredible and will make championship league teams so much more enjoyable and so much more popular to actually play with, because this is the teams you can actually build in the championship. Seriously, these are just some incredible players, and you can get them all by building a championship side, not a Premier League side, but championship side. Seriously, you have likes of Sandro, you have like Kalas and Anucha that still looks very OP. You have got the Matias guy playing for Sheffield Wednesday with like 88 pace and just some incredible stats, and just overall championship teams are going to be so fun to use this year. I just can't wait. But yeah, Wellington Silva, another great thing about Wellington Silva is actually you can link him with Elton, that also have been upgraded quite a lot. It looks like an incredible silver. But Wellington Silva with also 73 free kick accuracy and also 80 dribbling in his in-game stats will be one of the most overpowered silver 5-star skillers this year. Next player, we do have Salomon Kverkfelia. Now we have actually another center back in this episode, but seriously, Kverkfelia have some incredible stats. For a silver player, he looks just absolutely incredible. 80 pace, 78 defending, 70 physical, and the best part about this card that he is 6'5". Seriously, how is that even possible to be 6'5" and have 81 sprint speed? Seriously, these are just some ridiculous stats. Also, another great stats, in-game stats about this card are his 81 interceptions and 80 marking. And also, this guy have 70 jumping. Seriously, absolutely incredible. Just mind-blowing in-game stats. How can a 6'5" guy have 70 jumping and 81 sprint speed? It's just ridiculous. Kverkfelia might be one of the most popular, maybe not one of the most popular, but it will be one of the most overpowered center backs in the whole game. Seriously, these in-game stats and these base card stats looks absolutely incredible, and I'll be not surprised to see this guy in a lot of like silver Russian league teams or even like silver hybrids. Seriously, this guy has some incredible stats, and in my opinion, he looks like one of the better looking silver center backs in the whole game. You have actually quite a lot of great center backs this year, but this guy, holy crap, he looks incredible. And the last of this episode, we are going to talk about Senad Lulic, and this guy have managed to get himself a very, very sweaty position change, because when, as you can see on this picture right here, this is pretty much going to be every single Beast FC / Serie A teams in this year Ultimate Team. Seriously, you just have so many pacey players in the Serie A this year. It's just absolutely incredible. Perez with 83 pace. Zuniga, he's actually gold now this year. Caceres, you have Manolas, you have Jesus, you also have Mertens and Pereira. Seriously, I've never seen Serie A banks as sweaty as this year. Just so many quick players, and Senad Lulic with the very, very nice position change, he'll be pretty much in every single sweat Serie A team. But yeah, and the center backs in this year, I think you have like six or even seven center backs that have around 80 pace mark. Seriously, Beast FC teams this year are absolutely incredible. Even though we don't have players like Tevez, but you still have Callejon and you still have the Dybala that's also go this year. But Senat Lulic have some incredible stats. This guy have 85 sprint speed, 91 stamina. That is going to be a very important factor, especially for sweaty games in the Ultimate Team. 84 shot power, 80 dribbling, and 79 long shots. This guy looks absolutely incredible and just such a well all-rounded card overall. Very, very nice player in previous FIFAs. He used to be like a very, very nice, cheap, non-rare for starter teams. But this year, he's actually a rare card now and looks absolutely incredible. So hope you enjoyed this episode, guys. If you want to see more, leave a comment or like this video. Your support, you always appreciate it. And see you next time in the upcoming uploads. Peace.